anger only because of science. Nothing else for me. Science is everything for me in life. I'm coming from a small agriculture family from Tamil Nadu. I don't know anything about business, or neither my family knows about business. I know only one thing is the science. Nothing else I know it. And I think none of my family members are any associated with any political parties or anything. So because now the vaccine is getting into political, so I want to state that very clearly, none of them, my family members, are involved in any political families or anything else. I just, many people think, why I'm avoiding the media. I'm not a media savvy guy. I always like to find my science and ideas and work on those things. So I really not get into too much of media publicity and all that. It's not that I want to avoid the people, but that's very clear to me. And I think I want to quickly go little presentation. I'm going to touch upon 4 or 5 important issues that you're all asking, which I know what the questions are. And I will answer some of the questions if you have anything in the end. Are you able to see the slides? I'm going to touch upon my interaction on these 5-6 topics. Okay. Some of them may be little irrational, but I want to be truthful to the media and to the country. I think it's me and my wife founded the company. We are now touching 2,000 employees. We are almost invested $250 million, more than 1,500 crores invested in the company. And that is not important. But most important, we have 16 vaccines. We are not a company without a vaccine experience. And I think we have tremendous experience in vaccines. And that is what I want to highlight that. And we have various product portfolio, which I will touch upon a little bit, but not important. But we are not just restricted to COVID, but a lot of other programs are there. And I think, we're touching 123 countries globally. So it's very important for us. What we do in India is a reflection of the globally also. It's very, very important for us. It's a brand image of India, brand image of Bharat Biotech are critical for this serving this public health of these 123 countries globally. And I think we are the only company, I can categorically say, has got extensive research experience and extensive publication peer-reviewed journal. Many people say that I'm not transparent in my data. I think people should have patience to read internet and look at what our articles are and how many articles we publish. More than 70 journals, 70 articles have been published in various international journals, one of the top journals in the world. Nothing less than that. So I think that's very important. We are better than even an academic institute of a country of this country in India. And I think we are extensively positioned in the public review. We have more than 400 patents. That shows our innovative capability of a company that we stand by today, representing the developing world in a public health point of view. And I think, we are conducting clinical trials not just in India. Many people accuse me just being in India, we are hiding all the clinical trials. But I just look at it. We have more than 12 countries we have done a clinical trial, including UK. We have done 2 clinical trials. You can see here, we have done a TIBOT TCV human challenge studies. We are doing 1 right now, COMVAC 5 and Paratype E human challenge studies again in UK. And we have done phase 1 preclinical, phase 1 IND approved in UK, US. And we have done TIBOT DCV and NTS project. Phase 1 just completed in US also clinical trial. So it is not that we are an Indian company. We are doing a lot of clinical trials, various part of it. We have done 1 million children have been volunteered in our clinical trial, which I'll touch upon a little bit. And WHO said our TIBOT TCV with the first product in the world to come out. We have proven that India can innovate. India is not a copycat country. India can innovate. And we are the first conjugate vaccine we developed. And WHO said it's a breakthrough vaccine for typhoid control. It's very important because a lot of antibiotic resistance is happening in the globally, and this vaccine is a savior for the antibiotic resistance problem. And I think Gavi also said it's going to save a lot of children in typhoid fever. And we have done human challenge studies right in Oxford. Nothing new that. And we are doing a clinical trial in Pakistan. We are doing in Nepal. We are doing in Bangladesh. We are doing Nav Mumbai in Bombay with the CDC and ICMR collaboration. We are doing with University of Liverpool and University of Maryland partnership, Malawi and Burkina Faso. The reason why I want to say that, we are not a true Indian company. We are truly global company. We are doing a trial multi countries in the world that people should not accuse us. We don't know their clinical research experience. That's my point here. And I think Nature Medicine in 2018 said the treatment that made headline in the globally 2018, our typhoid conjugate vaccine was mentioned. Probably this is the first vaccine mentioned in the Nature Medicine from the developing world. No, not a single product from Nature developing world has mentioned in the Nature Medicine on this one. And I think we published in a lot of journals. And Zika, we were the first one to file a global patent. Even US was not aware of the Zika virus problem. Even UK was not aware of Zika. We were the first one to identify the virus and work before even Brazil incident came in. 2014 itself, we started working. 2015, we filed a patent. And 2015, December, where the Brazil incident happened. And you can see the public domain, it is there. We are the first company in the world to file a global patent on Zika. We are the first company against chikungunya virus vaccine. We want to thank CEPI. Now they've funded $14 million to take this program into Thailand, Philippines, and Colombia for an efficacy trial in three parts of the world. So that speaks that we are not a company of India. We are a global company. And I think our pandemic experience and emergency vaccine, people question us. These vaccine, HNVAC, pandemic flu came in 2009. In 8 to 10 months, all three vaccine, four companies have developed in India. And we didn't do any efficacy trial. It was again an emergency clearance. And please note down, there was no efficacy trial for this product. We have done an efficacy trial, not even multinational. Not even US and UK companies have done efficacy trial. They've got an emergency license for this pandemic flu. But of course, the history tells you that after that pandemic flu disappeared from the society. That's different. But cholera vaccine is also another one we are doing. We are taking global leadership in a various vaccine platform. We are also taking novel vaccines like Zika, chikungunya, Zika, and cholera, malaria vaccine, and NTS, non-typhoidal conjugate for African specific. We're taking global leadership on novel vaccines, which are no multinational is working on that type of action. We are taking global leadership in that problem in the interest of public health of the globe. And we have global partnership. We are proud to say that many countries have helped us. Everyone is a partner in our venue. Emergency use authorization. 2019, CDSO has formed a gazette notification. Please, I request every one of them to read the guidelines of gazette notification 2019. That they clearly said, if you have a platform is a proven platform technology, number one. Number two, safe platform technology. Number three, good preclinical trial data is available. Good phase one immunogenicity data. Phase two, good immunogenicity data is available. Then you can license the product, emergency license. That is allowed according to gazette notification. Many people just talking about a gossiping, everything in a different direction to just backlash on the Indian companies. That is not right for us. We don't deserve that. And I think H1N1 then, Ebola, a good example, Ebola vaccine was never completed a human clinical trial at all when Merck developed. WHO has done emergency authorization to do it in Liberia and Guinea, and those countries have done directly into human trial and sort of affair. And 2014, the license came in. 2009, they started outbreak. And 2014, the license came in. So that means emergency license is allowed globally. It is a practice. Even US government says, if you have good immunogenicity data, can be done in an emergency authorization. And I think, look at it, phase Merck Ebola vaccine, 39 subject and completion EMA 2020, they got November emergency authorization before phase 3 trial. Even Johnson & Johnson Ebola vaccine, only 87 people, they've done it. And they got emergency license in 2019, and they're done in Rwanda immunization program. It is allowed. People are not just, I don't know why Indian companies always targeted by everybody in the world. And I think you look at pandemic vaccine, Serum Institute, Panacea, Zydus Cadila, Bharat Biotech, all of us developed pandemic vaccine. And nobody has done efficacy trial. And we still got licensed in 2009. When a pandemic situation is there, the Drug Controller General of India has got authority. If the phase one and two is good, they can authorize vaccine license in the world. And it is not only that, it is a global practice. Look at China. And China, 108 patients, they got emergency license in August 2020. Sputnik, Sinopharm, Sinovac. It's not that I want to compare with Chinese vaccine or Russian vaccine, but I say the global practices. When Sinopharm, Sinovac has developed inactivated vaccine, and when they developed a vaccine, phase one, two, done in China, by then the disease has disappeared in China. So they can't do an efficacy trial. So they got emergency license in China. They went to Dubai and they went to Brazil, to that countries, to do the efficacy trial. And I think that you should understand that even by getting emergency license, they were selling in China, but they went to efficacy trial in other part of the world. And I think, you know, Covaxin is a simple two dose. We are the only vaccine above 12 years age right now. We are planning to do even children's trial also soon, submit a protocol. And I think product development is very, very simple. Look at it very simple. We look at science very seriously, not just like a product as a product. You look at the T cell response. When you have SARS infection, you see innate immunity comes like this and then goes down. And you have antibodies goes increases, T cell also increases. When you have fatal infection, when a person is dying because of SARS infection, you see the T cell response goes down very badly. When it goes badly, the person gets into serious issue. That is what is happening. The virus load increases. We looked at these signs very seriously, and that is how we built in our product portfolio that we should have T cell response as important, CD4 response in our vaccine, so that not only antibody response, but CD4 response also very critical if you want to stop this SARS infection, fatal infection in the world patients. And we looked at it. Ours is a pure inactivated vaccine, nothing great. Many vaccines are inactivated by polio, injectable polio vaccine. Pertussis, inactivated vaccine. So a seasonal flu is inactivated. Rabies, Japanese encephalitis, all are inactivated vaccines. It's a proven platform technology. Nothing great about it. And the nice thing about proven vaccine, the inactivated vaccine advantage is you have a membrane glycoprotein, nucleoprotein. Both can be a vaccine component. In addition to spike protein, many people are using spike protein. If spike protein doesn't work, what will happen to vaccine? People ask the question. Then nucleocapsid also can take over the responsibility of vaccine response. And that is why we are confident this will also protect the any UK mutant strains, and which is underway right now, a lot of analysis on that. And we are proud to say we partner with a public-private partnership with NIV and ICMR. Many people question, we have not validated our assays. Truthfully, we have all our samples. We validate with NIV Pune. We send a sample, blind sample. We write that data and we give it to them, and they analyze and they send back the data. We double blind studies. We have done it and we validate both of us assay. So because these assays cannot be done in non-BSL-3 containment. Many people question unnecessarily, we're not validated assays in other part of the world. It is not required, because in a BSL-3 containment, only place we can use the live virus into the place. The live virus cannot be used in any other facilities. So when you're using live virus, it has to be done properly, scientifically, and that. So our method is validated by NIV. Pune, please note down that one. It is wrong what they're spreading the news is on that. Fact. And we have platform technology, more than 300 million doses of virocell culture platform we produced. Whether it is injectable polio or COVID or Zika, chikungunya, rabies, Japanese encephalitis, rotavirus vaccine, which is the largest selling product for us. And all these vaccines are produced in virocell culture. It's the most proven platform, the safest platform in the world. And I'll just tell you that it's a very confusing slide, but we put all transparently every data when we submitted to each committee and when we got approval, when we had done the trial, everything is put in the plan. People question, we are not transparent. I don't know what is transparency to me when I put everything in the black and white like this. People still question transparent, because Indian scientists are cheap people. You can throw the stones on them on anything you want to. And that is a problem. And I think, you know, people ask, we don't have any data public domain. In a public domain, it takes in 6 months, 7 months, when the vaccine going in a fast track clearances, we are also under pressure. And we published, we are the only company published five articles. I'll give you an indication on this. BSL-3, we are the only BSL-3 production facility in the world. We are proud to say that. Even US government doesn't have, UK government doesn't have BSL-3 production facility. They have a lab, but not a production facility. I'm proud to say that India has got BSL-3 production facilities. And we are here to help any of the public health emergency of any part of the world, in the world, that we are ready to help them, anybody in the world. And I think, you know, you look at it, people ask a question, how many publications you have? You look at Pfizer, they have 5 publications, Pfizer. AstraZeneca, 8 publications. Moderna, 3 publications. Sputnik, 1 publication. CanSino, 2 publications. Sinopharm, 1 publication. Sinovac, 2 publications. Bharat Biotech, 5 publications. We are no way inferior to Pfizer in terms of publication. All international. Oh, they ask, where is the public domain? It's there in the internet. Somebody has to go and see that, read it, and then come back and ask the questions. They don't read that. And immediately in the TV, they say, oh, it's not in the public domain. They create a doubt and throw stones on the Indian science. It is not appropriate for us. We don't deserve that. We are working hard to help to create innovation in India, to create, inspire the Indian scientists. And I'm, whether it is a government scientist or a private scientist, I want to inspire everybody in this country. Scientists are the backbone. With our meager money in this country, we are doing the greatest science in this country in the world. In productivity per science of the Indian science is higher than anybody else in the world. We are doing everyone, every scientist is dedicating to science of this country. And I'm proud to say that. So we have 5 publications. We are no way inferior. And if anybody wants, I'll send the publication to all of you. No problem. Send an email to us. We'll send you that. And you look at, you know, the vaccine, Indian publication. Serum Institute, 0 publication. Pan-Asia, 0. Zydus Cadila, 0. Biologically, 0. Indian Molecule, 0. Whereas Bharat Biotech, Indian company, 5 publications, equal to Pfizer publications in the country, in the world. So we are matching with the global scenario in terms of publication. And I think we have done preclinical testing, because this is a very important for emergency license point of view. We have done preclinical testing animal in mice, rats, guinea pig, rabbits, and we published one publication. Preclinical testing in hamsters, non-human primates, done by National Institute of Virology. We gave the vaccine to them. They have done everything. And I'm really grateful to NIV Pune. But for them, I would not have done the non-human primates or hamsters challenging studies. Extremely good. And this is where you have in human primates, particularly in monkeys, both lower lungs and upper lung is clean from the virus infection. It's very important, because if your lower lung is cleared with antibody, if upper lung is not cleared, you still get infection and spreading the disease. Transmission will happen in the disease. So you need the antibody response will not protect. This vaccine is protecting both upper lung and lower lung. And we have done phase 1 clinical trial, 2 dose, 90% immunogenicity, 4-fold seroconversion. Because we use 90%, we get 100% seroconversion. But 4-fold is a benchmark in a vaccine field. So 4-fold is the one what we use as a thing. And in phase 2, we again 4-fold seroconversion, more than 98% immunogenicity data. 4-fold. I mean, otherwise 100% we get all immunogenicity. But we could compare with the convalescent, above convalescent, we should get 4-fold higher than that convalescent patient. That is how we call 98% immunogenicity. Based on that, and based on the safety data, you look at the safety data, people think, you know, safety data is not very important. Somebody said that, I'll tell you some of the story on that. You look at Oxford, Pfizer, Moderna, Sputnik, and Bharat Biotech safety data. We are less than 15%. Actually, as we go along in the phase 3, we found less than 10% of side effects, adverse reaction in any of the phase 3 trial right now, where we have done 24,000 people vaccinated. And we got less than 10% of a side effect. And I know media, everybody is watching, every clinical center, anything in adverse reaction is there. You look at Oxford, AstraZeneca, they have given 4 grams of paracetamol for every subject were vaccinated. That means they are suppressing the adverse reaction by giving a paracetamol. Whereas we have not given a paracetamol to the volunteer. So whatever the adverse reaction that is captured in the clinical trial is exactly 100%, even if it's good or bad, it's captured in 100% real time. Whereas this one, 4 grams of paracetamol is given to suppress adverse reaction. And we have done. And you look at the, you know, the already publication has come out, Lancet, where the adverse reaction, allergic reaction, anaphylaxis, and a Bell palsy, all that has been reported for other vaccine, mRNA vaccines, which I don't want to talk, but you all know it very much. But I think, you know, Covaxin phase 3 efficacy trial is going on. Out of 26,000 people, 25 trial sites, we have placebo control. This is probably the largest efficacy trial, probably in India or even in the developing world. And it's a 2-dose schedule, and we have already 24,000 people are vaccinated. And I'm proud to say that I'm really grateful to all the volunteers in the interest of the Indian company, in the interest of the clinical research. They came forward without any financial incentive. They came forward and volunteered themselves. I'm grateful to them. And every principal investigator, their efforts and hard work, I have to salute them. And I want to tell you, our drug controller, great people in that way. I'll tell you why it is important. And I'll tell you, manufacturing capacity, people will ask, we have 4 facilities coming up, and we are planning around 200 million doses in Hyderabad, 500 million doses in other city. We are coming up in that. By 2021, we'll have 700 million doses capacity. And as we speak, we have 20 million doses right in Bharat Biotech right now for the capacity of this thing. And many people say, I want to touch upon, we'll take it out, this one. I just want to say one thing. Some local company in recent press release yesterday in the news, they said, oh, safety is like a water of other companies. Only 2 or 3 companies have done efficacy. Other vaccine is like a water safety. Safety is like a water. And I want to deny that. I want to say that, you know, it hurts us as a scientist. We work 24 hours. That's what they deserve. We deserve that type of bashing from the people. No, I'll tell you very simple. I have asked a simple question on UK trial, clinical trial. You asked a question, UK AstraZeneca clinical trial, whether 60%, 70%, 90%. Which one is the clinical trial efficacy of that country? Nobody knows. The one says 60%, one says 70%, another one says 90%. One says high dose, or low dose, high dose. If I had done that type of clinical trial in India, Drug Control of India would have shut down the company, because we have to have 3 parameters in a product quality. Number 1, product quality. Certificate of analysis. That means certificate of analysis means if I say 6 microgram in my vaccine, I should have 6 microgram in my vaccine. I say, now after my doing a clinical trial, then second step is required, method validation. That means whatever I'm putting 6 microgram is validated by each individual in the company. Each different parameters, we looked at all the direction, it's still stable as 6 microgram. That's the standards practices. And then our national testing protocol approval. 3 steps are involved. If I say 6 microgram, I'm sorry, I've done a clinical trial 3 microgram. I missed it. So it's called English word called serendipity. I don't know what is the meaning of serendipity until this now. Now I understand the British language of serendipity. Serendipity means honest mistake. That means I can drive in a car and kill somebody and then say, I can say serendipity. Honest mistake. If I have done that type of clinical trial in India, my drug controller would have shut down this company on quality issues. This quality, you said 6 microgram was not there in your clinical trial. I would have got 5-6 PIL case in India. And National Human Rights Commission would have said, I have given consent to give a 6 microgram vaccine, but how come I have been given 3 microgram in my clinical trial? That means you have taken me right on this matter. Somebody can National Human Rights come. But in spite of that, our drug controller was great enough to, in the public interest point of view, he allowed that vaccine to sell in India. And I'm proud that. And I want that vaccine to be there in India. And I congratulate for our drug controller giving a license for that also. Only UK MHRA gives, so we have given the trial here. Whereas Europe says we will not accept the UK data. US says we will not accept the UK data because they have to clean up the data, clinical data. Whereas in India, we do all systematically in a 200% transparent, 200% honest clinical trial, and we get a bashing from everybody. Everybody in the news media gets into bashing on us. That's not right for us. Please help as a scientist to survive. I want startup to survive in this country. And I want innovation to survive in this country. We have done a wrong, please point out. But why is it you don't question the UK trial? Nobody want to read that. Because Indian scientists are easy. Indian scientists want to bash on another Indian scientist. Maybe they want to prove that they're above Indians. I don't know if they want to say above Indian. Are they going to get a British passport? Are they going to get American passport? I don't know why. They have to be clear. You talk facts. If UK has done it wrong, you talk about UK also. If I have done wrong, you talk about India also. No problem. Talk about equal rights on this matter. Because I have to bring this because some other company has banned me as a water. That is why I have to tell this. If I have talked a little rashly, please forgive me about that. Okay? And it hurts. It hurts a scientist who works 24 hours and he gets hurt bashing by people for the sake of selfishness and for the sake of, you know, to show they're intellectually above others. That's not right. We don't deserve that. Thank you very much. I'll take the question, whatever you all have. Tamanna is there. Tamanna is there. Tamanna. Yeah. Oh.
Why couldn't we have waited for the company's patient trial and publishing the data before the emergency?
Because the emergency license gazette notification of 2019 gives that opportunity for me to get emergency license. When a law provides me, why not I? Right now, I ask a simple question. My Indian company, I don't want to name that company. They have done 1,200 people. They don't have phase 3 data. They have only phase 2, 100 people immunogenicity data. Did they publish any paper? Did they publish any paper? But they got license, no? In India? How did they get license? On a phase 2, 100 people immunization data, they don't have even 1,200 people safety data also. Whereas I have 25,000 people safety data in this country. I have 1,000 people of immunization data in this country. So when other company got emergency license based on the UK data, not on the Indian data. Indian data, only 100 people data, nothing else. And I'm still not, I have to appreciate the drug controller because to give a permission so that the public health is benefited in the country, in the large interest. The emergency license is a provision given to us. And on after phase 2, we can get the license. But that also given with the conditions. It is not a public, I'm not going for selling it everywhere. It's like a phase 4 type of a permission they are given to us. Thank you.
This question is from Mr. Milan Sharma, okay, India Today. How much efficacy is vaccine showing in interim results of phase 3? How many more days for the phase 3 trials to end in India?
Phase 3, I mean, media should help me to promote the volunteers to come. And one side effect happens, immediately writes about India, oh, adverse reaction there. You see how it hurts the clinical research in this country? But we don't want to do a clinical research, but we want a product to come. That's not right. You have to encourage us to do clinical research. But if you are doing unethically a clinical trial, please blame us. No problem. No blame. But we need maybe February, March, data will be coming out on phase 3 efficacy.
So what basis was the vaccine phase two trial done on children above the age of 12 years? How many participants out of 380 were below the age of 18 years?
We have not done about 12 in phase 2 at all. Sorry. Okay. It's only in phase 3 out 12 years is included, not in the phase 2. Am I right? Yeah. Only in phase 3 we included phase 2 or 12 phase above. 3 phase 3 is 18 above.
And phase 2 is 12 and above. We have a small.
Phase 2 only, phase 3 only, above 12 we have taken.
Phase 2,
above 8.
And it's the DCGA permission. Basis is DCGA permission.
And all these documents, CTR, you know, it is there in the public domain. All our clinical protocol is in the public domain. It's nothing secret. And we call CTD, registry. We register every clinical trial.
And the publication is on
MedArchive. And MedArchive is the publication is already there. You look at that publication.
This question is from Ms. Priyanka Pulla. What is the meaning of clinical trial mode? Will Bharat Biotech supply to India's immunization program? Was any efficacy analysis done among phase three participants?
No, we have not done anything. Phase three efficacy. No, we have not done it because we can't, you know, we can't, you know, open the trial right now. We can't open the trial until the second dose is over. We can't open the trial. And also, Priyanka, please remember, we have given the trial, ICWA is a U.S. multinational company. The reason we have given that trial to them, because they don't believe Indians. They don't believe Indians there also. You want another multinational company to do the trial. And I gave it to ICWA, which is a Quintel, earlier name called Quintel. We gave it to the clinical trial, everything to them. They are doing the data management. So to give sanctity, a third party is doing the trial.
This question is from Ms. Shalini Bharadwaj. What study data led the SEC to recommend Covaxin?
Okay, that's a very good question. Very simple. I'll tell you very simple. Excellent animal challenging data in hamsters and monkeys. You got 100% protection. You can't get a better than. I can tell you, among the animal challenging models globally done, our NIV animal challenging data was the best. Please underline this statement. It's the best animal challenging data that has been done. And we have comparison of all animal challenging data published in recently in Indian Journal of Medicine. How comparison of this, upper lung, lower lung, everything is taken into consideration. Very scientifically done. But when we do good scientifically, we don't get recognition. We want some UK people to publish it. Then we get recognition. And strong neutralizing antibody titers. Generally considered indicative of efficacy. Antibody response is correlated to the immunogenicity and correlated to the efficacy. But I'm not claiming the efficacy yet. But I can say it's a strong. You put rabies, Japanese encephalitis, hepatitis B vaccine, the pandemic flu, seasonal flu, all of them are based on immunogenicity data, not on efficacy data. Just immunogenicity data, which are correlation protection. And third one, long-term persistence of our immune response. Because it's giving almost, we have 6 months data that giving a long-term protection of our vaccine. That's number two, three. Number four, it's also protecting against heterologous strains. We have done and published paper in Medrix, is the publication is there. It's coming in international journal on January 10th. It's coming out of public domain journal. And it is published heterologous strain. We have taken 3-4 strains and compared whether our antibody correlates with our human sera, whether neutralizes those things or not. We have done, it neutralizes. Signaling. And then we got high degree of 4-fold seroconversion. And we also looked at S1 protein, RBD, N protein. Nobody has looked in the world on N protein because N protein and nobody has got inactivated vaccine. So we have got inactivated. We looked at nuclear protein also, how much is the response it is giving. We have taken all the three parameters. Probably immunosis data, we are far better than anybody else. Not comparable with mRNA vaccine, we are comparable with any ad vector, okay? And we also look at another one is, and the excellent safety profile of 25,000 people data available with us on safety. Which Indian company has got a safety data of more than 1,000 people? Nobody. We are the only one has got 25,000 people safety data in the country, okay? But we don't get recognition for that. That's the sad part of it. But I want to say another one, no, I'll leave it there. I'll leave it there. But I think I can come on the others.
So the next question is from
Pallav Bagla. Mr. Pallav Bagla is asking, how many doses has Bharat Biotech stockpiled till now, and how much can it add every month going from here?
Sir, we have 20 million doses right now. We have 20 million doses. But we're aiming to 700 million doses capacity in four facilities, three facilities in Hyderabad, one facility in Bangalore. So four facility will be ramping to 700 million doses capacity. That's how we're aiming on that. But certainly, you know, a lot of hardship is going on. You know, logistics, reagent, chemical coming in. There's so many problems we're encountering in that. But certainly we'll be there at a very high scale capacity.
This question is from Ms. Prabha Raghavan. Was any interim efficacy data submitted to the SEC for PESVO?
We have not submitted any interim efficacy data at all, Raghavan. What we did is we have produced highest antibody response, long-term immunogenicity, and how neutralization protection is there. I want to, because you write a lot of scientific article, a lot of echo sound. Can you hear me? Echo. So what we do is, what we have done very strategically is, we take all human sera sample, we put the live virus and test the neutralization assay. Many people use a pseudovirion. And pseudovirion.
So that was Dr. Krishna Ellar, Chairman and Managing Director of Bharat Biotech, defending the controversy that has erupted and the questions that have been asked over emergency use approval being granted to the Bharat Biotech or the Indian coronavirus vaccine called Covaxin.